Pass me that red one over there. Never mind. Say hello, they're all watching.
Hi. Welcome to the Olipus Hale. Behind the scenes. What's up? I'm finally here at my mom and dad's house. So, I'm taking over right now. No, I'm just kidding. So what I'm making is I'm making Szechuan ribs. So what there was like a big log spare rib, and then I kind of like cut it into like smaller pieces, and then we used the Tupperware pressure cooker, filled it up with water. So well, I put the ribs in first. I kind of like stacked them around so that they could fit, and then I put like a bunch of cilantro, green onions. You don't have to chop it up because I just had them in pieces, like maybe like that thick.
And we're gonna we'll type the recipe for you guys too.
I just eyeball everything, but I'll just have my mom write it down.
Yeah.
But so in the pressure cooker, 20 minutes. When it comes comes out of the microwave, let it settle. Let it depressurize. So now what I'm going to do is we're going to season this. Where's your salt and stuff?
Onion salt right here.
This one?
Right here. It says onion salt on the jar.
Okay, I guess we're going to use onion salt.
That's my favorite salt.
So when it comes out of the microwave, you depressurize it, take it out. All the remaining liquid, what I did was I strained it out. So I strained it out because now you have like a very aromatic stock pork. It's basically pork stock.
What did you put in the pan?
I just put oil. But strain it out, all the stuff that's in there, because now you can save that for like if you want to make soup or chicken long rice, you know, something.
The broth, you mean?
Yeah, the broth.
So I can save it?
Yeah, you can save it.
So once it cools down, I can put it in a freezer container?
Yeah, you can cool it. So let it just, you strain it out, let it cool down. And then you can save it for something else. So now you can make soup. I mean, it's raining thunderstorms over here in Hawaii. So I mean, it's perfect for soup. If you want to make like chicken noodle soup or something. Well, it's not chicken, but you know what I mean.
Whatever soup.
It's soup. So now you don't have to go to the store and buy pork stock.
Word.
So I seasoned it. Season the others. Now it's okay.
Oh, sugars. Fill in.
Okay, so season it. And then I have a pan. I might change moving this one over
yeah,
here.
Yeah, just move it to the stove so they can see the
okay,
stove.
So
on Facebook, they can see it.
I'm going to move this here.
Do you need this?
Mm.
What?
Just
don't use a middle thing in there, yeah?
No.
They're making Szechuan.
Okay, so
ribs.
Now what I'm gonna do is typically you wanna like pat off all the moisture that's left on here just so that you get a nice brown color.
What is that?
The stock. Watch out. So in this pan I have oil. Make sure it's hot. I'm using veg oil. I would use sesame oil, but because sesame oil doesn't have a high smoking point, it'll just burn in the pan. So we're gonna sear it.
Freezing metal. Just don't scrape my pan.
No.
Just saying.
Watch out, baby, the oil.
Do you still need this?
No.
Yes, I have a very full house today.
You have
enough? Okay, so I'm just searing.
Do you still need this?
So you want to put it on high. I mean, when it's all smoking and you want it to sizzle like that.
Do you still need this cutting board?
No.
Do you have a recycle bin?
Nah, no.
No.
Of course not. Let's not say
it's not in here.
So we seasoned it. I'm just using the tongs. You don't want to use metal.
No.
You want to use metal on the non-stick pan because you don't want to scratch up all the coating.
But
so I'm just using the tongs.
To push down on
but
it.
Because I'm a professional.
Okay.
No, I'm just kidding.
Anyways.
I'm just using the tongs and I'm just kind of pushing down on the surface of the meat. You want to put the flesh side down because on spare ribs, there's like a, there's the bone side and then there's the flesh side. So I'm just using the tongs. You don't have to use the tongs. I mean, you can use like a spoon. Like Tupperware.
So it's on high right now.
Yeah, so I put it on high so that you get nice flavor.
I didn't wash this. It was just with my laundry, so it smells good.
Fine.
Okay. I'm a very clean person.
Mm-hmm. Okay, then let me grab this. Grab that. What else did you put? So we have minced garlic, sliced onions, and he's putting bell pepper.
So we're making Szechuan ribs.
Szechuan ribs. We gotta have our fix hot sauce. You know what I'm saying? We gotta have our fix. Can't cook without this if you're making a Szechuan. We have oyster sauce. What is this? Patis?
Fish sauce.
And fish sauce. Patis.
You don't have long. Where's that other? What? I didn't think of the other sauce.
I have balsamic vinegar.
I mean, I'm just searing it just because you want a nice color, and like kind of like a.
I like this fish sauce better.
North Nam.
This one is super salty.
North Nam. But Uncle Tanner.
Huh?
Uncle Tanner's watching.
Oh yeah, hi Uncle Tanner.
The German one.
The
German
one.
The one
that's from Germany, yes. The guy that taught your dad all of his Samoan phrases.
Yeah, is he half Samoan, half Holly or something?
Yeah, can I have a plate?
Afakasi.
Thank you, Itzo. My mom bought it for me. How appropriate.
Oh,
what? You're only going to sear the meat side?
Yeah. You're just going to sear the meat side just so that you have color. Because we're gonna braise it a little after.
In the oven? What the heck does braise mean?
So braising is like... kind of, you know, like when you're making shoyu chicken?
Yeah.
And like there's like soup or...
It's so hot. We don't want to touch each other.
Okay. I'm making Szechuan ribs.
Szechuan ribs.
Oh, Uncle Mitch is watching.
Yeah, but Uncle Mitch is stuck in traffic. So by the time you pop.
You kind of want color like that.
Only on one side.
Like, just on like this side. Because this is bone side. It's curled up this way, so it's not going to be flat.
Okay. Show them the sear. Shmia. Ooh, that looks good. That's on camera too.
Okay.
Camera one, camera nice. Two. Camera one. Color. Yeah, she's still eating mangoes, Connie. And you know what? My mom is still looking for more. I tell you, we can eat mangoes all day long. When it's mango season, you take advantage of the season. And eat as much as you can. They're watching Jokoi again.
I mean, just like some color. You don't want it to look like...
papa'a.
Yeah, like...
papa'a or like burnt.
I mean, it's okay if it's kind of like...
You want it to be golden?
You want it to be like...
you know... Mitch is gonna be here soon, and Mitch is coming and he's cooking too, so this is gonna be a long live. You guys have all been warned. Okay, we can turn off the heat now, cause
no, leave it.
This pan stays hot for a long time.
Leave it.
Press plus. There.
Fine.
Okay, there. Did you show them this here?
Color.
Okay, and then.
So with everything cooked inside here,
Trisha wants mangoes.
The oil, what the bits and stuff in here. So you're just gonna put this inside here.
That is the onion and the green bell
pepper. Onion, green bell peppers, and the garlic.
And then, do you use green onion in it?
You can, but because I flavored the water.
Ow! Ow! Garlic! Don't put it in the pan. Oh, there it went.
Oh.
Not good.
Okay, so
oh my god, it smells good.
Did you put ginger?
Are you done
in the water? Yeah.
What?
Dad wants me to put some of this shrimp in
the
bowl.
Because he can't pop this up in himself and eat it right out of the bowl.
Well, he can't fit in here with all you guys in here.
Keep it on high. Make sure there's enough oil in your pan. Like, you don't want it to be too dry.
But you don't want it to be drowning and greasy.
Who's coming over here, you said?
You don't want it to be frying.
Mitch is gonna come and make poke.
Where's the cutting board and the knife?
For what? What do you need it for?
So I can cut this into...
Oh.
More.
What time is it right now?
Use this one, because this one collects juices.
Can you open this, Mom, please? My nails are too long.
Wait.
Okay, so...
Oh, there went the onion. My nails are too long.
It looks okay. Yeah.
Okay,
so... gonna put like
a tablespoon. It looks like a tablespoon.
Maybe like two.
Okay, 2 tablespoons fish sauce.
Why did you toss it into the sink?
The flies is gonna come knocking on our doors pretty soon. I better get my bug assault ready.
Maybe
that looks like a lot. Like the salt content.
I've gone it.
Four. Maybe that's 4 tablespoons.
1/4 cup of oyster sauce.
Hold on, hold on.
Yeah,
oh, cuz
you stink.
Maybe the lip. What's
a tablespoon of sriracha.
Not just any sriracha.
The fix.
Not paid, not sponsored, not one ad. I don't get anything from the coupon code, you guys. That's just a benefit to my followers. That Tupperware 10 code. I don't make any money off of it. It's just
okay,
something
so
that
now,
they did nicely
with
for
the
me.
Sauce going in there, everything oh that was God, like so baked stupid. Onto the...
Get out then. That's you, you smelling.
No, that's
where's
it.
This stock? This
oh, stock. Right here.
So now since you saved some of the stock, if it's a little too thick for you, you can always add like some stock. Add some stock. If you want to add more veg, add more vegetables, you can add more vegetables.
I have carrots. Kano.
No.
Kano.
Okay, so after you sear, I'm going to just cut this, I'm going to cut this in between the each bone.
Forget,
so you see these one bone. Mm-hmm. So you're gonna put the flesh side down, and then you're gonna see skin side.
Yeah.
Then you just cut in between.
But why don't you do that in the beginning? Like
because it's easier for you to sear. So you sear it one time.
Yeah.
And then you cut it. See, now you have individual ribs.
Word.
Okay.
So 20 minutes in the pressure cooker.
So
20
minutes pressure cooker. Season. Season it. Sear it.
Yes, I will type this all up for you guys.
Cook the vegetables in here.
Okay.
And we're going to put this back inside.
And
here.
It's the pan has been on high heat from the beginning. Until I turn it off and you turn it back on.
And then. Just be careful though, because there might be some like pieces
teeny bones.
Some small bones.
So you guys are in for a treat because we've been on live a couple times today. Mostly on Instagram though.
So just try your best.
Those are some fat ribs.
I mean, and then I just let this cook. Okay, and then one thing.
What? What do you need?
Okay, so if you're cooking at home and you have a cutting board and this thing slides around like this, either get a wet towel or a paper towel, wet it, squeeze out the water, put it on your counter, and put your cutting board on top. So now it doesn't really slide around.
But this one has rubber feet, so it shouldn't be sliding around.
I still don't trust rubber feet. Like the stuff that they always say that it doesn't move, but it always ends up moving.
Okay.
So put a towel, wet towel underneath your cutting board.
Hi, Gail.
Or a wet napkin. Soak the napkin in water. Squeeze out the water. Just so that you guys stay safe. Don't cut yourselves.
And don't damage the cookware. Yeah, this is how you're gonna do ribs. This is a lot easier. I usually do ribs just straight in the pressure cooker because I don't really care about the braising and all that stuff, but RJ is the chef person, so he's picky.
Okay. I'm gonna put this back here.
Can you guys see?
Yeah. If your liquid doesn't really like come up high, you can always readjust. So I probably would cover this.
Hi Amanda, we're making Szechuan ribs.
I mean, if anything, you can. I'm just probably gonna just use the
so
whole thing.
There we go.
Just
there went
the
my
thing.
Stock for later.
So I probably would.
There, you guys can see that better. So it's on high.
I'm just gonna readjust. So maybe like another tablespoon of fish sauce.
You didn't even taste it yet, though.
I know, but because you're adding the liquid.
Oh.
Another tablespoon of that. So I probably would double it. So 2 tablespoons fish sauce and sriracha and 1/2 cup of oyster sauce.
And then you just boil it to death?
Sauce.
Do you top it with green onions?
You can, if you want.
Are you going to add up the rest of the onion and bell peppers?
I can.
Yeah, because I like veggies.
Can I see?
Would you have to bring it back to boil? Yeah. I moved the camera here so they can see everything. Turn the TV. It's so loud. Pretty sharp, yeah, my knife.
So small, though.
What is? Because you're using the wrong one. I don't know where the other knife is. I think it's in the dishwasher. We used it this morning. There we go. It's starting to boil.
So I used one whole onion. We're making Szechuan ribs today.
Hi, Shirelli. Romeo, Shirelli. Show her your new hairdo. Did you put your hearing aids on that you got from the doctor today?
So, if you want to see how
you're
I cut
not,
it...
You're not... here. Shirelli is on. Show her your new hairdo.
The whole...
Oh, he's shoving his face or shrimp.
Then you cut the bottom off. And then I cut the top.
Yeah, then you can just pull it off.
And then I just cut this guy. Why is everyone yelling?
I don't know. That's Rosie. Rosie just types in caps. That's Rosie.
Okay.
Ta-da, then you just throw it in the yard and grow it.
So typically, they say the seeds are the spicy part, but that's not true. It's actually
it's a bell pepper.
It's the rib part. That,
is
that
it?
White part that goes in.
Wait, no, but I like that part. It's a bell pepper. Bell peppers have spice.
Yeah.
Damn. Excuse you. You're just showing off now, and they cannot see. There. Because right now it's just boiling on the stove. He's slicing.
I'm just adding more vegetables.
Yeah, RJ, there's 102. I haven't had numbers this high in a long time. I have rally tonight, by the way. It's a bridal-themed rally at 6:30 at Oahu Vets if you guys are free. They're giving away a piece of cookware, you guys, tonight. Must be present to win.
Okay, let's go then.
Hi, Susie. We're making Szechuan with ribs. Lowest spice, but yes. Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, doesn't it's not like crazy spicy like a jalapeno or a ghost pepper, but it still has some. So I added two bell peppers. You can use any color. We just use green because that's
what
my
mom
had.
Yeah.
One whole onion, white, yellow onion, Maui onion,
and then you just boil it. For how long?
So you're just gonna. So I leave it. I put it on high. Put it on high until it starts boiling, and then when it starts like rolling, when you see little bubbles like this, that's fine. You just want to leave it like that.
So you don't have to cover it.
You can cover it just to I would cover it if you want to keep the steam inside and cook it faster.
But if you want to reduce,
what I'm trying to do is just cook it down slowly, but reduce the liquid as well. So that the flavors kind of just break down.
So you have a sauce.
They condense into the sauce.
So this is what we used. This.
So this is, I just like.
And this.
You just eyeball this.
So I'm going to put it back because we don't have room.
Just kind of keep the flavor profiles the same. Keep them stuck together.
If you guys are not following him on Instagram, he goes live when he's working at Roy.
So if you aren't following me on Instagram, I do go live at my job. I work at Roy's Hawaii at the Waikiki location. I usually will go live if it gets really busy.
So you can watch.
So you get
cook.
To see like the action on my
from inside the kitchen.
From like back behind the scenes.
Yeah. Emily, can you go throw these seeds on the ground outside? Here, go throw these seeds outside. Oh my god. Oh, Mitchell's here already? Perfect timing. Because we're getting ready for the next dish. Ooh, you guys are in for a treat.
My Instagram, ooh, it's spicy.
What?
It's pretty spicy.
Uh-oh.
My Instagram is Yo It's Roro, Y-O-I-T-Z-R-O-R-O. Or just look up Roro, R-O-R-O.
Yeah. Or you can look at one of my tags.
Or just
on my
look at my mom's Instagram.
I tagged
him.
Hi. It smells really good. He does make it look easy.
And that's
way
it.
Way better view on Facebook.
So
yes.
That's basically like the prepping and the preparation progress, like process. So you can kind of consider this a one pot meal. I'm using too much air quotes.
Yes.
But after everything is in here, that's pretty much it.
And I never posted the video of Mitch's leg. This morning we talked about it. If you guys want to see it.
Big Romel and small Romel.
Comment that you want to see it and I'll know. I know to post it. I didn't post it because it is graphic.
So I just turned it down a little because it's now it's kind of like just.
You do want to see it.
Not crazy.
He's going to make poke now.
Oh, I make beautiful desserts. Thank you.
Okay, Mitch, your turn. The kids get
okay, so we're going to just leave this on the stove. Just let it cook.
My mom's worried about his leg.
Let it cook on the stove now.
I know, right?
There should be a stove. A show.
Who? RJ. Okay, wait. I'm going to move you guys back over here.
Rosie. Yeah, I actually have hair. This is the first time in...
Forever.
Since I was a baby.
Years.
You guys get to watch it.
I've ever tried to grow my hair out.
Okay. Where's Mitch is now? While RJ's is boiling, Mitch is supposed to do something.
Peace out.
I gotta leave here. Romel has to leave here in like 10 minutes. I have rally.
I mean, you can eat it now. I mean, that's what the pressure cooker is for. But yeah, so you're just gonna let it cook. We're making Szechuan ribs. So right now this is the reducing process or reduction process. Or this is technically what braising is. So there's like a bunch of liquid in there. Your meat's in there. Vegetables are in there. The stock. And then you just let it cook like at a low temperature, so just like slowly boil.
Onion,
rock salt,
and just leave it on low like that.
Onion, salt,
look at Roro, R-O-R-O.
Onion, oh my god,
look it up, I'm too tall.
Oh my god,
I have to stand back here so you can see everything.
What
is that? What are you cooking? What is this?
Szechuan ribs, brother.
Szechuan ribs.
Yeah, I'll go.
There's always stay awake in class.
He eats. Oh, French cafe. Well, that explains the gut. What he said? Onion, Hawaiian salt. Watch out.
Our main course,
yeah, Hawaiian right? Coming in. Hawaiian coming in. So this is going to keep boiling. I'm going to move you guys back. I'm going to type the recipe out for you guys and post it so you guys can get it later. So Hawaiian salt, onion, what else you said? Knife?
Yes.
Knife. Knife, what else? Oh, sesame oil. Sesame oil. What else? That's all.
Simple.
You get 10 minutes, go take a bath. You should have taken a bath earlier. So Mitch is making, I don't know, seafood. Oh, Shirelli, when did Romel get hair? Everybody thought he was bald.
High school.
Okay, wait.
Hi, Alicia. Alish.
Where the boys?
Amelia. I've always had hair. I just shaved it because the army, it's just easier. Just a sweet onion for me.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Perfect.
Romel, can you show them the fish head?
A fish head.
They all want to see a fish head.
What is fish head?
It's in the cooler, in the bag.
Oh my god. Where?
You can cover it if you want.
Oh, it's in a truck.
Can
it's,
I turn off the
it's
heat?
It's too high.
No. I don't want to cover it though. I want it to reduce all the way.
It can still reduce.
Rosie said hi, Uncle Mitch.
Hola.
Mitch not limping, no? No, just leave it.
Strong like wood. Need bigger hook, I think.
Oh my god.
Hi,
is Mitch married?
Watch out the baby.
No comment.
That is a good question.
In other words, no.
On paper, I'm
married
is.
To myself.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You go?
We're taking numbers, so. Take a number.
You want to take another match?
We'll start a waiting list.
This is actually sweet.
Sweet onion. I know, but wait, you gotta show them what he's actually preparing. It's hot with the stove on.
Hi, Winnie.
Hi, Winnie.
Rosie.
People prefer Facebook because the view is wider. What?
Mom said hi, Mama Feli.
Oh.
Rosie.
Rosie said hi, Mama Feli. Why are you using gloves, Mitch? Because it's fish.
No, I'm using gloves because from the gym and
oh,
my hands all bossed.
He has manly hands. He doesn't want to scare you guys off with his manly, callousy hands.
You have a bowl to mix everything?
A bowl?
Or a Tupperware bowl?
This is a Tupperware house.
A Tupperware bowl?
I have lots.
With a cover.
Look, yeah, right there.
Wait, with a cover, he said.
Oh. What about up there?
Up there is big. Those are huge bowls.
Well, yeah.
Why? How big do you need a bowl? How big? Like,
Uncle Mitch can reach.
Wait. Okay, wait.
That big.
Check it for everybody.
When you open the cooler, it's already in the black bag.
So this is the baga. This is the fish that hooked my leg. See who got the better side of the, you know. And this part of the fish is its knee.
One plastic bag.
What kind?
Trash bag.
It's in a plastic bag. Yeah.
Oh, okay. How big is the fish head?
Oh, it's a big bowl.
Oh, you know, this is too big?
Yeah, way big.
Maybe can use this one.
Yeah, like this. Yeah, perfect.
Here, Christine. Go take your pot.
Here.
Here what?
Give it to Mama. Give it to Mama.
Okay, what's happening now? Just rinse this out.
Mom, I'm leaving.
They have to go drop off the fish head.
To who?
Auntie Tommy.
What happened to the other fish head?
They made soup out of it. Okay, what are we making now?
Just like an appetizer, like poke. It's ahi / opihi.
That's a big, beautiful man. Which one? So anyways, back to what I was reading.
I don't even know what order.
There's, so get ooh, this one and this one.
Which guy in a wheelchair that had a fishing hook snag?
What?
Was that Nephi?
Nephi
Aquina.
Oh my God. Sure, he's the only one I remember that was in the wheelchair.
Yeah. He died already.
He did?
That's no.
Oh. Yeah. Ooh, the breeze feels nice.
Oh, well, sorry.
So one whole sweet onion.
Yeah.
That's one whole or half.
Okay. You can put less, but I just figured I'd throw the whole thing.
No, you're going to be late for school.
Oh, Gail said hi.
This is Ahi. Oh, Gail's back. Hi, Gail. Oh, my God.
Which guy, Cheryl? He was in a wheelchair.
You answered that question already.
No, that's why she said not Nephi.
Oh, I don't know. I don't remember.
Oh, you're making sauce.
Oh. Why you like sashimi?
Oh, I don't
that's
know.
What Dara said. Yeah.
Oh, so I guess he's making poke with one and sashimi with the other.
Yeah.
This was the fish you guys caught the other day.
Yeah.
Before your flake.
On Saturday.
So anyways, if you guys want to see that video, let me know and I'll post it with a disclaimer because it is graphic.
Oh yeah.
The injured from the hook.
Oh my God, no, I don't remember that. Yikers.
What happened?
From our high school.
Somebody got injured from one hook gaffing his brain.
Ooh.
I never heard that
I
one.
Remember that.
Me too. I don't want to cover this. The steam is blowing.
Got injured from gaffing one hook.
Maybe the hook would fly up and would catch his head.
Wow. Ouch. Knock on
was
wood.
Was he our grade?
Trisha, just don't look. Romel already posted it, and Mitch did, but it's not public. I'm sure there's a lot of fishermen that would love to see that one, though. There's a bunch of them that started following me after the Ahi shootout.
This is probably looking like...
Oh, no. But it happened.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? You're not the only one.
You know the picture of the guy with the Marlin bill in his leg?
Oh, God. Ouch.
Like, in his... It was like... It went all the way behind his shin.
Ugh.
Through his calf.
No
to the
thanks.
Outside.
Lizette said, looks so good. So is fresh caught fish best to eat the same day or the day after?
The day after.
Sure. Yeah, it's gotta be iced down.
Yeah. If you're that hungry, you can grind them that day. But,
but it's really only for big fish like this. Like, yeah, like small kind fish, like a coolie, like that. You can eat them.
You just want the meat to firm up.
The Desiree asked you what year we grad.
Oh, what year? They grad
2010.
Don't believe. 92 and I'm 94.
2010.
Hi, Misty. Do we eat the fish raw? Yes, we do.
Yeah.
Hi, Rosie. No, I don't want right now.
Why not?
I don't feel like eating raw fish right now. I ate poke this earlier today. That's why. From Times.
Houston.
Hi, Misty in Houston.
Look at that, blood meat, everything.
Show them to the camera because they like they you know. There's so much videos that get worms in the fish, and I don't believe that get worm like that kind. Not our fish.
Some do.
Yeah, but
there's parasites.
You can see it.
Yeah, you can see when the meat, but as you can see, no more the worm.
There's no worms.
Still wiggling.
There's rings of life.
Still beating. Look, still fresh. It's some fresh. Still beating. Still squirmy.
That's a dolphin. I don't know what sound does the ahi make when you catch it.
1986.
If she grad from Campbell, maybe she knows your brother.
Oh, from grad from Campbell.
I don't know.
She's probably know my brothers and sisters.
Yeah, probably. Hey, Miles, you coming skinny, huh? No.
When you saw him. When you saw Miles.
On top, low in them is feed. They lift like a lot.
No, I'm getting bigger. I mean weight wise.
Oh my god. Noemi wants some of this.
Me too, I'm getting rounder.
I'm trying to stop getting rounder. But it's hard to do when you love food, you know what I mean? My mom was like, oh, like, go eat Genki. I'm like, Mom, we just ate McDonald's.
What happened to the slab of ahi in the freezer?
I gave it to your brother because you gave him nothing.
Hello, Erica. Say hi.
We don't eat to live. We live to eat.
Say hi.
Lisette said, bring me one ahi and I'll throw you in my hotel. Free vacation.
Oh,
Mitch would take that up.
Automatic.
Mitch needs a vacation, yeah, I think.
We'll also throw in, if you come to Hawaii, what is that? A charter, either on the Emily Christine or on the
Kamale. Whichever one is running. So it's onion and fish.
Yeah, so far.
You don't need hot sauce, nothing?
Oh, we may use the vaihu after.
Oh, yeah.
Then we use the water.
They've not seen that before, you know.
Oh, the water came out of this?
I guess so. Hmm. Is there a hole in your Ziploc?
No, in here.
I guess. Oh, water. Oh, no, because you probably had more stuff in it, so it displaced the water. How come you have to leave it like that?
I'm trying to throw it out. It's frozen.
Oh, it's frozen. Can you take one out?
Yeah. See, they're like stuck together.
Oh.
Well, in Hawaii, we have these things called opihi. They're like the escargot of the islands, straight from
Big Island,
Hilo.
Wow. Does Mitch have a big boat?
A very big boat.
Boat. I don't know. Don't ask me.
You got a spoon?
Yeah.
Okay.
A big one or a small one?
Small is fine. Yeah.
So you're actually gonna shell them? Are you gonna eat one right now?
Yeah, but I just deshell them. So you just take them.
To make it easier.
You throw them in a book.
What is it? It's a mollusk.
Mollusk? Do you even get limo on top?
Or grab the shell. Use the shell for one scoop up.
You can eat this straight from the sea.
Oh yeah.
Just go. Pull it off the thing and suck it out.
You just probably go for like $400 a gallon.
What?
Yeah, deshelled.
That's perfect size. Right,
$400 for a gallon bag.
Yeah.
Deshelled. Because that's all meat and no shell.
Yeah.
You guys die from trying to get these things.
Really?
Yeah, they get smashed against the rocks and sucked under. And
really? There.
You can see now what I'm trying to do.
Is that Lavellini?
But how long is this supposed to cook?
I don't know. He said you can reduce it down if you want, or I'm going to turn it off already because I don't want the vegetables to turn into mush, which it's already soft.
And they're still frozen.
Yeah, so it's going to be watery. Where you got these from?
What? Opihi. Pino.
The Opihis.
Yeah, Pino. And I just came in today.
Oh.
Yeah. I don't tell anybody my secret.
I know. We eat like kings and queens. That's when they get lucky catching stuff or getting stuff. Yeah. If not, we're eating ribs every night. Because the ribs was on sale.
Or honey glazed spam. If you don't eat honey glazed spam with brown sugar once a week, brah, you don't know what you're missing. Spam is like steak over here.
Yeah, it is. It's because what we can't afford. Hi, Isaac.
Oh, this is like watching the kind of dishes in the pizza. Here we go. One.
I like watching this kind though.
For real?
Yeah.
Two. You like
it? It might seem boring to us, but they like watching this kind of stuff. Like,
you can show the rock salt.
Oh.
And some by Ehu.
How much?
Oh. That's too much. Too much. Half that.
Like this?
Yeah, for now. Yeah. You can always add in your sesame oil, little bit shoyu.
Sesame oil.
Yeah.
How much?
Just right on. Yeah.
No, I was off today, Teresa. So I was home. And
you get green onion.
The chili pepper water. Oh yeah, we do.
Yeah.
How much of this?
Two caps, maybe.
We use the cap to measure this. I wouldn't know how much this is really. I'd say maybe like a tablespoon. So two big tablespoons.
Yeah. With the green onion.
Green onion. She's gonna be like, hey, you guys are eating all my produce. I was gonna make salsa. Cause I don't know where the rest went.
Yeah, we'll use the whole thing. I go buy some more.
No, she, I don't know where she went shopping for something. I told her plant the bottom so it can grow.
Yeah.
Then I go to the pool. I did, but I just walked in it. I didn't want to like get my hair wet because I just washed it. There's no special occasion. It's just one of those like days that everybody came around.
How long was on?
I don't know, probably an hour.
Just stopping by.
38
before
minutes.
I go to gym.
Yeah, I gotta go to school. I'll see you guys later.
Bye.
Bye, honey. See. You kiss her, but no kiss me. That's a lot of that.
Baby, no.
I know where I rate now.
Where did my mom go again?
She going to drop off the head.
Oh yeah, drop off the fish head and come back.
You put
tomatoes in this.
You can if you want.
We get tomatoes like.
We will add after. But the tomatoes might make them a little bit gushy.
Oh. Get cilantro.
Nope.
Oh yeah. I forgot you don't like that. Maria is hungry now. It is Opihi, yes. What happened?
What's that? Come here. Daddy laughed and he's crying.
A little bit show you. Here we go. Pick it up.
Okay. Oh my god.
Almost done. There's some more Opihi.
She saw Ramel leave.
She wants to go.
I'm on a diet, so living through you guys. Oh.
Oh, this is all keto free right now.
That is actually.
Keto, whatever. What do you call it?
Keto.
Keto.
This one is.
Yep. All you can eat keto right here.
The onions might add carbs, but it's small kind of carbs.
good carbs. And it's good for the complexion. Not too good for the BO, but it's good for the complexion.
And you're going gym after this?
Oh, yeah. Yes, yes, yes. That is a must. Gym life now.
Oh, my God.
It's healthy life.
Jim, he still goes to the gym, even though he got a hook in a leg.
I know everybody at the gym goes, hey, I see your what you doing here? And you're not limping.
And you're going to bleed out while you're on the machine.
Alexi. You know, if that hook went, what is that?
Trish said, if get inamono.
Oh, inamono.
Inamono.
Roasted
is kukuina. Is Mitch Hawaiian?
Yes, I am.
Not even.
Yes. Hawaiian, Samoan, Chinese.
I'm just kidding.
Lithuanian.
Mostly Lithuanian.
I'm like 100% Asian, really. Caucasian.
What do you want?
Ah.
No, you cannot have that.
What a shoyu is that?
Oh.
Because we're going to put the shoyu.
This one is a different shoyu. Because that one is the...
Still alive. Get him.
That's the swan, the Filipino version one.
No more the aloha. Oh, perfect.
Aloha.
Ah.
This is the only one you should be using.
But... You know, in Hawaii, let me show you real quick. No.
What?
Wrong already.
Poke a hole in the top.
No, right there, watch. So we do it in Hawaii now, okay? Watch out, twist. Here we go. Bam. See that? Perfect. Perfect measuring cup.
Now it's all fishy. That's okay. Wrong already.
Well,
now
you
guys
like,
learn.
You don't like opihi?
I don't care for it, no.
You don't?
No. Just because it's super oceany, like salty. I eat the fish, but look at the furries on this. You can't really see it on here because like the thing gets, it doesn't know what to focus on.
That's what you call opihi oromot.
Or.
It's not a butterfly.
In other words,
it's the mood.
Opihi pubic hair is what he just said. But this one get choked. It's like an afro on an opihi. Like, can you even eat this part of it?
No. That's just the limu that grows on top of it.
Yeah. This smells like, the smell of this after I pulled it reminds me of the Eva Beach. When you would go pick limu in Eva Beach back in the day.
Yes, sir.
This is what the bucket smelled like after grandma them pick them and they stay walking with the swashy buckets.
Oh, yeah.
That's what it smells like.
Ooh.
And you know what? No more limo in Eva Beach anymore.
You gotta dive.
For real.
Yeah.
Before, you could just walk out on the reef and pick like a 5-gallon bucket. And but you know what? I think people are over picking.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. What's going on? That's enough with that ball.
Should be good.
That's enough with the ball.
Let me see. I cannot read and work.
Christine, what you playing with?
She's playing with the ball.
Oh no. So Paul.
Yeah.
That's it?
Well, yeah, done deal. Thanks for grind.
Time
simple.
For grind.
Oh, you know what? So a little bit. Wait, what are Hawaiian socks here? Let me wash my hand real quick.
Heather says she's coming over for dinner. Save me a spot next to the Caucasian. That's what. There.
Okay, here we go. Here we go. You just need a little bit more. A little bit more on top. Okay, perfect.
There was my high blood pressure.
That up. Frozen the thing with me. Make them all good now. Here we go. Here we go. Tell her sample the OPE people. Here we go.
I will, even though I don't care for it.
Don't do it.
Oh, it's good. Yeah. Bueno. Oh, I forgot that he's tall. You can only see his mouth. I gotta get the onion.
Ooh. Ooh. Runaway onion.
5-second rule. I eat them. It's my floors. We just cleaned it.
Well, I think it's good. Mitchell, they said you eye candy.
Oh, mahalos.
Oh, here comes the rain again. Ooh. Wow, that's really good. Are you gonna take some to go? Oh my god, he's plating it for you guys.
You know what? I gotta make them look patina.
Pretty.
Yeah.
Then we can take a picture of it. No more kicking of balls in here, please.
Kicking of balls.
Yeah, don't.
It's not good or healthy.
Next to the Lithuania rough hand so-called Hawaiian. No, so funny. It's eaten raw. Yeah. There, Mitchell plated it. Okay, I'm gonna do like this. Can you guys see it? Here, look. Oh my god, the kids. There. So he used the shell to make it all fancy.
Fancy, fancy. Call this the Hawaiian.
So when you
chili.
Shovel it in your mouth, just watch out for the ormot. It's really good. Share. What did you say?
Lunchtime.
It's raining. Yes. This dugyut baby, she's been sweating all day long. It's yummy. You want to taste it? No. Okay. She don't want.
Want some?
No.
It's like cereal.
No.
No milk.
Uncle Mitchell, no.
Okay.
Yummy. So I'll pile. So now I gotta type up that recipe. I gotta get the other one from RJ, but I will type up the recipe for you guys. The OP is from Hilo.
You can probably find it on Oahu, but you gotta go.
Desiree said, you lucky she's already married. Hi, Unita. We just finished making braised Szechuan ribs. And, oh.
And this is the apa
matanza. And the poke. Opihi and ahi. Here you go. I know it's sideways, sorry. Somebody take a screenshot for me. Ready, go. That way I don't have to do it later. It always looks nicer when they do it. Ta-da. They said it looks delicious. It's really good. It tastes good. I don't particularly care for opihi, but that one was really good. Okay. Say goodbye, everybody. See you next time. Bye.
Bye.
You know, Ziploc, yeah.
I get.